نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. So inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to begin with those masail, aqeedah masail in relation to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. So previously we finished off on the points which Imam Bajuri mentioned in relation to the divine attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the same way now, it's important for us to know what is necessary for us to know in the rights of the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, what is impossible to attribute to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, or what is permissible for you to know in the rights of the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. So Imam Bajuri mentions, وَيَجِبُ فِي حَقِّ الرُّسُلِ عَلَيْهِمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ الصِّدْقُ. So it's necessary to know in the rights of the messengers alayhim as-salatu was-salam truthfulness. Now why is this important? Because we know that the opposite of truthfulness is kadhib, to be a liar. And lying is not something which can be ascribed to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And the reason being for this is the aqeedah of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is that the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam are infallible. They are ma'asoom. Lying is a sin. Whether a person puts it into the major sin or minor sin, it's a sin. Something which is disliked, something which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companions alayhim ridwan to refrain from and not to do. And the same way from the Quran we find that lying is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes. The curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon the one who lies. And Dajjal is the Dajjal because he's going to be one of the most biggest liars that you would come across. So lying is not something which is from the traits of the unique perfect people and the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not from the traits of a believer. Yes, if someone does lie, you would consider it as being a sin. Now, ascribing such a thing to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam is incorrect, because the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam are perfect beings, elite beings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in many verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirms the truthfulness of the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. So like in Surah Yusuf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yusufu ayyuha Sidq, Yusuf, O the truthful one, afitna aftina fi sab'i baqaratin. Inform us, give us the khabar about the seven cattle. And the same way you find in Surah Maryam in relation to Sayyidina Idris alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِدْرِيسِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. And mention in the book Idris, indeed he was a man of truth and a prophet. So you'd find that here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, Prophet Sayyidina Idris alayhi salam, he uses the term Siddiq, and for both of them the word Siddiq is used, which means it's truthful, meaning the prophets alayhim as-salatu was-salam are the ones who are truthful. Kadhib, being a kadhib, a liar, cannot be attributed to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. Now, if we look at the life of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we find that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was always known as as-sadiq al-ameen, the truthful one. And who recognized him as being the truthful one? This was the polytheists, the mushriks of Makkah. So the ones who didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and didn't accept the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were the very same people who would call him and title him with these names. And they would say that he's a truthful one. So the mountains, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathered upon the mountains and called everyone towards the mountain of Safa and Marwa, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the message that I want you to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, testify that there's no one worthy of worship but Allah, and testify that I am the messenger of Allah. They at that time, they experienced a dilemma, meaning the people of Makkah. They were thinking to themselves that how can we even reject what this man is saying, meaning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because we've always known him as being the individual who always speaks the truth. Never have we heard a lie from him. So this was the disbelievers affirming the truthfulness of the Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So to ascribe such a thing is incorrect. From Quran and Hadith we find that this is incorrect. But logically, what would it mean? A person has to use his aql as well. So why would it be incorrect to ascribe lying to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam? Because Imam Bajuri says, وَالدَّلِيلُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَنَّهُمْ لَوْ كَذِبُوا لَكَانَ خَبْرُ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى كَاذِبًا وَهُوَ مَحَالٌ. That if you say that they lied, and that would mean that the khabar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us and informed us about, meaning even the books which are revealed to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, everything would be a lie. It would mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a lie. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling a lie. It would always go back to that. So if the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam are those people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brought the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we say they are lying, it would mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is lying. And the same way that book which is revealed and the message that they brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to mankind, it would mean that that's also a lie. So now everything that is contained within that message, meaning the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it could be a lie. The Anbiya alayhim as-salatu wasalam could be a lie. The thawab, the azab, jannah, nar, everything could be a lie. And this is incorrect. Ascribing this to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu wasalam means that the very message that they bore is a lie. And then the one who gave them the message, ma'azallah, would mean that he's a liar. So astaghfirullah, ma'azallah, this would be incorrect. So wahuwa muhalun. Imam Bajuri says that this is impossible to ascribe. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect, dissimilar to creation. Those traits and things which are found within the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be ascribed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now looking at the divine qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whomso Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make perfect, he makes perfect. Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam are the perfect beings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has made them infallible. The Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam cannot sin. So kathib is a sin. It cannot be ascribed the same way to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to remember this point in regards to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam with the utmost respectful words. Ameen bijahin nabiyil ameen.